got to get it to him if they're going to win. They got to get it to him if they're going to win.
And it'll cut the lead. 2-5 if he hits it. The shot is up and in. They say it's out. And evidently, Matilde must have jumped into the lane too soon, so the points will go ahead.
The play she was in too soon, it counted.
5 points now for Kent Adams. 4 minutes and a half left in the first half as Fort Bell Matilde controls on the right side of the lane. Back to Jarvis. Jarvis pulls up in the lane. Hit. No good. Ball Red Sox do. Now the pass goes underneath the car back to Martin. Martin in the left corner still. 1:03 left. Here in the first half of play, and Adams controls back to Treadwell. Treadwell puts the ball on the floor, goes to Carr. Carr in the lane.
Leaves it by 12, 42 seconds left.
Jennings on at the free throw line, slapped away by Adams when they try to go back to Graves, but Petunzi comes back up with it. Lower control down the left side of the court. He puts it on the floor. A.B. works on the fence, and Redwell has Jarvis now switching off and taking him is Martin, and the pass goes out to Lower. Lower puts it on the floor. Oh boy, what a Ryan. Now to Graves. Graves moves it.
Kill us on the bowling.
He gets to Jarvis. Jarvis back across the timeline, loses it and picks it up. He's on the left side of the court. Now goes to Lohr. Lohr dribbles the ball. Now to Graves. Graves will right the left side of the lane. Trying to go inside. He does. The Jennings turnaround jumper. No good. Rebound by Martin. Slides off in and out of bounds. So they missed a chance of pulling closer that time. So Petunzi will inbound the ball. That's Lower the left side, trying to go back to Graves on the right side of the lane. Slapped out of bounds, though, by A.B. And Eddie Graves will inbound once again for Petunzi. Gets it to Fortale, now to Jarvis. Jarvis to the free throw line, pop. Yeah, oh, well, that goes like a win. Rebound is taken down by Fortale. Goes off him and out of bounds.
Garcia Valley,
once again, has an opportunity to cut the lead to 12. If they can get a bucket
here, but that's going to the balls.
Balls go back to Redwell, and they work against the Petunzi press. Down the left side of court, Redwell goes, stolen away by Jarvis. And little Steve Jarvis has four underneath. He goes for it. And Lohr lays it up and in, 39-23. So that Lohr and Jarvis work the ball well. And they go back to pressing. And now the pass is saved by Arcadia Valley, but Martin has tipped it back to Graves. Graves hands it to Jarvis to Petunzi. So Petunzi can now pull out to a 19-point lead if they can hit this one. The pass goes underneath to Fortale. Throw out jumper. No good. Rebound, Mueller. AV, and he goes to Dave Carr. David Carr for AV works across the sideline. And now, the foul is going to be called on Graves to Petunzi, and that for him will be foul number three. And checking in the ball game now for Arcadia Valley is number 21, John Smith. Smith checks in, Redwell checks out, and the pass goes to Ball. Ball goes underneath, it's tipped away, but with the rebound is David Carr. Carly says no good. Rebound, Mark Carly says no good. And we've got a foul, it's called underneath the basket. It's going to go against Petunzi and Jeff Fortale. Mark Fortale, that is foul number one. Personal foul on him. That sends to the line. Martin, his shot is up and in. 4 points now for Mike. And he's one of them that needs to get hot. If AV hopes to come back, his second shot is up and in. And they've got a call. No shot. He was over the line. So Arcadia Valley has pulled some boners and has hurt themselves. So Petunzi will get the ball back. 39-24. They lead it by 15. And here's Steve Jarvis, Mark Petunzi, working across the timeline. He has John Smith on him. Now to Fortale. Fortale goes to Graves at the free throw line. Now to the left corner to Lohr. Lohr dribbles the ball. He has Martin on him. Now back to the top of the key to Graves. Graves goes underneath to Jennings. Jennings turn around. Jumper no good. Rebound by Mueller, maybe. And he goes to Ball. Ball loses his dribble. Now has to go to Carr. They better hurry. Dave Carr puts it on the floor. Drives across the timeline. Now sets things up. He goes to Smith on the left side. Now the left corner of Martin. Martin tries to go to the ball. There's a slapped away by Petunzi. Coming up with a loose ball of Fortale. And Jarvis has it after Fortale just hands it back to him. Steve Jarvis dribbles the ball on top of the key. Now to the right side to Lohr. Lohr goes back to Graves. Graves at the free throw line. Holds it up high. Going against the man-to-man defense. Drives down the baseline. Lays it up. Arcadia Valley and Martin can join them all across the timeline. Arcadia Valley losers in the conference tournament. Petunzi could be defeated. Now being threatened Arcadia Valley trails it by 15, and it's not out of the realm of possibility yet. And here's Jarvis going to Moore, over the right side. If you remember the Central ball game the other night, it's very possible Central led by 16. And Jackson started coming back and almost pulled the ball game out. They had a chance, but just didn't quite do it. And Chelsea misses the shot. AB comes back with a rebound.
Size lead. And now the downcourt pass for Potosi goes to
to Fortell. Fortell to the left side of the lane to Jarvis. Jarvis sets the green. Straight to the lane. And no good. Brother in. Rebound by John Smith of AV. And he gives to Dave Carr. Dave Carr with 4 seconds left in the third quarter. Shoots. No good. And it goes out of bounds. Up the top. There was 4 seconds left in the third quarter. And let's see. Dave Carr will inbound it. They're going to have to really hurry to get this thing off. And Carr gets in hand.
Get that ball really into the big balls. We're not going to roll.
Fourtell with two, and that's really about it. At the line for Arcadia Valley will be number 31.
across the timeline. Now to Lauren, the left side of the court. Dishes off the Gray. Straight drives down the baseline. Trying to dish off the side of Fort Mill. That's no good, and it's intercepted by Bridwell. Bridwell comes back for PV. He goes to Adams. Adams puts on the floor, turns around, and jumps. No good. They call foul on Gray. And for Gray, it might be foul number four. He picked up a couple of quick ones a while ago. The foul is on Eddie Gray, and it is foul number four.
He'd have him out there if it had been a passing
throw. At the line, Kid Adams of Arcadia Valley. And for Adams, this might be his last game as a high school senior, as it is starting to look bleak for the Arcadia Valley Tigers. The first shot is put up and in by Kid Adams. And for Adams, that is 8 points. Adams' second shot still to come. And it is off the front of the rim and falls in. 49-35 in Arcadia Valley. Senior. Adams is a 6'5 senior. State High School Activities Association and Regional Radio J98. Okay, we're ready for action. Arcadia Valley will inbound the ball to get it into Bridwell. Bridwell and Arcadia Valley trail it by 12 at 49-37. Popping the outside is Arcadia Valley. No good. Rebound for Sophie. And Laura comes back with it. 3:35 left in the season for one of these two teams. Right now it looks like the Sophie will advance unless Arcadia Valley can pull something out of their head. Popping the outside.
Bounce
it behind you, 37, and trailing by 14, still without a rumble possibility, though. The pass goes underneath, and it's tipped up and hits the top of the basket. And they say that we'll take it out of bounds, folks. Good join the ball for Arcadia Valley.
And Martin gets it in to Bridwell.
Back inside to Martin. Martin has two players to contend with. He goes back.